Today, we have to keep it short a little and just do one thing, to update Quill to be more powerful and rich with its features. But hey, if you are new to this channel, I'm Peter and I upload 1 to 3 videos weekly about web development. If that sounds interesting to you, subscribe. Okay, so like I said on our intro, today we should extend our Quill editor and make it work with multiple options and upload of images, because that's what we intend to do. And hopefully embed YouTube videos on it. Okay, so let's go to Quill docs format, because that's what we need to see, all the toolbar options. And I will leave down in the description the link for it. So clicking standalone, because I think Quill documentation is pretty bad. It does explain everything, but it doesn't show, and it should have a default for all the toolbar options. But anyway, that's just my opinion. So after going to the standalone view page source, and here let's copy the div with ID toolbar container. And here it is, copy, and let's see where we used our okay, so it should be admin posts form .blade.php. yeah, and here on our editor, let me, because I kill editor of content text area. Here we can put, let's see, let's put our toolbar. And for some reason it's not formatting anything. Commando is just a... I'm not sure. Okay. So after that, if you see here, we need highlight.min.js. Oh, and there's something that we need from our let's see, we don't need the formula because we are not doing math here, so because it gives another dependency of ktex, we need highlight.min.js to put it here, because we need the code features, so putting it before, oh my bad, we need the script tag and the src. Okay, sorry, and we need to specify on our modules syntax true and toolbar container. Okay, so here before and after doesn't matter, it's an object. Let's put this modules object syntax true toolbar container, which is the ID of the div that we copied from this link. So let's check out running our server on a terminal, php artisan serve localhost 8000 and logging in actually, and password. Okay, let's edit this, and we have few things. We have a new image import. Actually, I want to save it. Okay, so we have an issue here. Let me, how I can do this. I can't, oh, okay. We have an issue here. Our Quill editor uploads images, and we'll do that on the next episode because we don't have time right now. We need to change it, because right now he uploads images as base 64, and it's too large for our content text. So if we have 2 or 3 images, it's like big, and it keeps the images in database, and we don't want that. We want it to upload to a file system, and retrieve it as a link, let's say. So we'll need to do that on the next episode. We can embed an video save. Okay, it's totally working and I really like it. It's perfect. Exactly what I wanted. Let me see. Anyway, it's just an iframe. Good. So we can put links. I'm not sure what this is. And I don't really like it. We can put some code. Okay. Let's say function. Oh. Not sure. It's a bit weird why it's not showing everything. So let's check this out. Formats. First of it is fonts. Okay guys, so for some reason I lost the sound of this video and the filming, of course, and I'll try to explain everything I do, and yeah, hopefully you'll still understand what I did there. But here I thought that we still need some dependencies, for example a link or a script, and checked out the page source from Quill standalone with full things. Tested a bit our implementation. It was missing the colors and the font options. Checking out again the documentation and see if it was something there. And I checked out even the version of CSS that we had on our Quill. But unfortunately this wasn't the solution, so we had to search on Stack Overflow to see all the options necessary for Quill. And our solution with DOM, so for example toolbar with HTML elements, didn't work, and we have another one with a JavaScript object, which is a little bit better anyway. So I'll leave down in the description this link for Stack Overflow, and you can copy the toolbar options from there, or you can pause this video and see it there. After taking this, we put it on toolbar options object, and okay, remove. I had a similar solution that I got from the documentation, but it didn't have any image or video input. Okay, and we're removing the formula because we don't have any math. Or if you need it, you can leave it there, but you need to import another dependency. And moving the options from there. Okay, moving it to link, image, video. And yeah,
put it at last. And it is working, and we have all the options for Quill. Of course, this error we will fix it on the next episode, because I want to implement a custom upload method for images from posts. Okay guys, thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe, and I'm sorry for this inconvenience of not having any sound.